It is an Orlando institution. The Russell Home for Atypical Children has been part of our community for more than 60 years. They care for those who perhaps would not have anywhere else to go.
Well, earlier this month, the home for special needs clients was hit by thieves. WESH News' Dave McDaniel looks at what was taken and how hard it will be to replace.
Taking care of 27 special needs adults and children requires a lot of equipment and a lot of expertise. But at the Russell Home in Orlando, a golf cart was lifted by thieves earlier this month. It's a golf cart. It'll take a while to replace. The afternoon and after school activities are something everyone at the Russell Home looks forward to. The smiles don't lie. You can see the joy. It was a different story earlier this month when thieves hit at this home for special needs. A golf cart which could haul around anywhere from 6 to 8 clients to let them visit a nearby park they could never reach without it was stolen.
Oh my gosh.
The things have changed.
They were so upset because, as I said earlier, that's their limousine. That's the one thing that they can get in and they can go for a ride and, you know, wherever they want. Of course, one of the workers drive it, but that's their chariot.
Now the activities they used to take to a nearby park have to be done here. It limits their ability to get out and get fresh air and exercise.
Instead of their after-school program being fun in the park, now, you know, they get to stay here and they're on the playground. We don't take them out on picnics too much on a regular basis.
The Russell Home was founded more than 60 years ago by Blair's grandmother. They don't get state or federal funding, and they still can't believe someone would come down their private drive and rip them off, picking on those who have a hard time fending for themselves. I'm told there's no way they could come up with the $9,000 to replace this very special golf cart unless they have a fundraiser. And that will take several weeks at least. Reporting in Orlando, Orange County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.